back to them. Hold on. Introducing the first participants. First, the following contest is the opening contest. The first match of the night.
We won, Keith!
Introducing first in the corner to my right, Saint Stallion! And his opponent, now in the corner to my right, the Aztec Warrior! Disrespectful from the Aztec Warrior right there. Hey, you gotta do what you gotta do sometimes, even if it is kind of stretching the rules a bit.
Referee's definitely giving a lot of leeway here. Nice chin lock in the blocker.
Now he's able to use his feet to get out of it. Keeps a hold on him. Nice head cover into the pinning combination. Cover two.
Already able to get that foot on the second rope.
Stallion comes in, drops the leg, trying to maintain the momentum. And again, foot on the bottom rope there.
This is gonna hurt.
What go where I thought he was. Nice maneuver there by Saint. And Saint now into the single leg Boston Crab. And now transitioning into a cloverleaf. Now this is beautiful from Saint Stallion as far as strategy goes. He pulls him away from the rope. He's pointed basically no man's
land. From what we're going to know about full wrestling, you know ring presence has to be a key thing. Like if you know where you're at in that ring at all times, you've got a clear key to victory.
Look at the strength though. El Rey able to break the hold using that leg strength. And now Stallion, though, going to try to transition almost into a modification of an STF here.
Referee right on top of the action,
asking El Rey if he wants to give it up. Smart, once again, look at the strategy by Saint Stallion, taking away both his legs and his arms, making sure he can't get to the ropes to break the hold.
Again, when it comes to a guy that relies a lot on his strength, he's got to take out that leg. If he's got to convert some strength to just stand up, that helps you out a lot if you're more of an agile fighter.
Absolutely. Strength does you no good from your back. Nice side headlock here by Stallion. Stallion needs to stay on top of El Rey, though. And, okay, El Rey jumps Stallion all the way to the outside there.
If you'll pardon the pun, I think St. Stallion just went for a ride.
Stallion absolutely went for a ride and he landed with a thud. Referee starting to count up to four and here comes the Aztec Warrior. El Rey can smell the momentum coming into his corner and he's going to take absolute advantage of it here. El Rey drops him right on his head with the DDT and that may be enough cover. Two count only, you got to think, had he hooked the leg, that had to have been done.
Guess he's got a hard head.
Definitely in the case, and now El Rey gonna zero in right there on that leg. Gotta make sure he doesn't get put back in the cloverleaf. Oh, again, dropping all that body weight on that left knee joint.
Again, while a strength guy may need the strength, this is a leg. You take out the leg of an agile guy, you can't jump as much, that's for darn sure.
Absolutely, just like I said, you can't use strength on your back. You definitely can't use speed unless you're on your feet. The Aztec Warrior, both of these competitors respect each other. And once again, cover, nonchalant, and Stallion able to get out at one. The Aztec Warrior keeping advantage, standing side headlock again. And once again, that relentless with that side headlock, Stallion trying to reach out desperately for a rope or something to cause a break, and there it goes. Finally gets it, but once again, El Rey able to wrench and continue applying the pressure. Stallion has got to find a way out of this thing.
Yeah, with the strength of El Rey. Roll up.
Roll up into the cover too. And just like that, there's that speed we were talking about earlier. Obvious advantage for St. Stallion, but right back after that knee.
Again, El Rey is fighting smart. Go for the leg. Like, you take out the leg, you take out the speed.
Absolutely. It's all about taking out that vertical base of St. Stallion. El Rey coming in and... Oh! Once again, the body weight and the forearms colliding onto that knee. And again, dropping that axe handle. Each one of these moves completely debilitating. Here's the cover, too. Two count only. Completely debilitating. Look how much he put his weight on Stallion in that awkward cover. He put his body weight on Stallion, so he had to use that leg to kick out.
Again, I know we're talking about strength mode, but that's only half the equation. You always got to have that fighting spirit just to keep going, even no matter what.
Absolutely, you got to give it up to St. Stallion. Most men would give it up by now, and he uses the other leg that he still has some strength left in to kick the Aztec Warrior off. He's got that separation. He needs to take advantage of beautiful basement dropkick right to the knee right there.
Again, both these guys know exactly what they're doing. They're vets of the sport, but again, you take out the leg, you take out the opponent for the most part.
Absolutely, and now El Rey in some trouble here. Stallion could be thinking sharpshooter. Oh, look at this. Beautiful, an inverted figure four here. The Aztec Warrior screaming in pain.
El Rey
finally gets to that rope. But how much damage has now been done to the knee of the Aztec Warrior? Both men favoring their knees. You gotta think that we're back tied almost to even. This is almost like overtime at this point.
Overtime it may be, but these guys are still giving it their all for this thing. You gotta always give them that.
You are right about that. El Rey, over here in the corner position. Stallion, oh nice, rolling senton into the corner. Stallion trying to roll him over into the cover. One, two. Three count only right there. St. Stallion only moments away from picking up a victory in the opening contest here.
Yeah, you can tell the gas tank's starting to get a little low, but these guys are still giving 110% as much as they always do.
I would agree about that. You know, the gas tank at this point has to be right near empty. Stallion, you see him reaching. Oh, he came down for that leg drop. He saw El Rey try to move, and he may have jarred that knee out right there.
There's a reason they call it the high-risk district. Oh, what? He rolls up.
At the very last moment, Stallion able to get off, but you saw him, he landed, he could have jarred that knee right there. Right back, sending El Rey back into the dominant position and now into a hammerlock. And El Rey may be only moments away from a victory right here. Stallion cannot move right now towards El Rey. He's gonna find some other way out of this thing.
Again, same thing as I've been saying this whole match. You got the fighting spirit, and there's the pin.
Two count only. Smart move there, though. Force the break. He may not have gotten the victory, but force the break of the hold by using El Rey's body weight against him.
Smart strategy on the behalf of the All Saints diet here. Again, both these guys giving it as much as they can get.
Nice body splash in the corner, and El Rey back on the offensive, rolling it into the cover two. Oh, two count at the very last moment. St. Stallion able to get that shoulder off the canvas.
Again, one thing you always learn about St. Stallion, yeah, he may be quick on his feet, but when you try to take it out, he'll just keep coming at you no matter what, even if he's got a hop towards you.
I'll tell you this much, El Rey has got to be thinking about finding some way to put St. Stallion away. If he's got one big move left in the repertoire, he's got to be thinking about calling on it at this moment, because St. Stallion is so resilient, he could possibly pull this off. Oh, but he gets caught here. What's the dragon sleeper he's looking for? There it is. Got him in the dragon sleeper. El Rey, nowhere to go. Maybe forced to tap. This is the resiliency I talked about a moment ago. El Rey has got looking for a counter, trying to find a way, trying to turn his body into it. Oh, but look at the strength here. El Rey back to his feet, able to successfully turn that in. Oh, and look at that transition into a dragon sleeper of his own.
Yeah, both of these guys are about as resilient as you can get, but where one's got more speed, the other guy's more. We're going to see which one wins on this.
Absolutely, into the cover, hooks the leg, two! Oh, very last second. Stallion able to get that shoulder off the canvas.
Like I said, if El Rey has one more home run left in him, he needs to be trying to get it right now. This thing could be only moments away. Stallion just proved he can change it on a dime. Which one of these guys wants it more? El Rey sends him in. Stallion! Nice leapfrog.
Stallion
trying to hook him. Stallion goes through.
Oh,
El Rey.
Two count only. El Rey barely getting that shoulder off the canvas.
I know we were talking about the leg earlier, but again, you hit somebody in the spine, that's got to be one heck of a debilitating move. I should know. All right.
Absolutely. And now Stallion on the offensive here.
Into that standing side headlock.
El Rey going to try to create some separation here. Firing off shots into the midsection, but Stallion lets go of it. Stallion inadvertently creates the separation, but smart move here. Gets him into the corner.
Again, getting in that corner is one thing you always got to do. You always got to watch out for the reversal, because if you miss it, it's going to hurt.
Stallion took a little bit too much time right there. Oh, both men running right into each other. Test of will. Oh, there's a knee! Right on the button! This is going to be